Welcome to Evolution 2016. We've got some more. Dude, Street Fighter V action has been going crazy all day long.
It's currently on three streams right now.
That's
for
right.
Reference.
And I am James Chen.
I'm Stephen Lyon, a.k.a. Sajam. We have some fun matches for you guys to check out. The winner side top eight.
That's right. This is going to determine the top four winners who are going to make it to Sunday tomorrow.
In the Mandalay Bay.
That's right. But before we get to that, we've actually had a lot of matches that have been played off stream.
Right.
And we were able to capture some of that gameplay. So we're actually going to be able to check out some of the highlights from those matches that we had.
Yeah, and a lot of these matches, people who are here didn't even see.
Yes.
So a lot of people get to check them out. You can see them here. This is Ino versus Sian Chang. And Ino won this 2-1. You can see there's a couple of clips we have for you guys, but this is at the end of the round. Ooh,
right.
The size bonus spacing, I like it. But yeah, Sian Chang, really strong Texas player. Unfortunately, out of the tournament now, you can see the confirm, yeah.
Yep, and here it goes.
I really like his pressure, I really like his Nikali. It's too bad that he's out of the tournament.
Yeah, I mean, he's one of the players that I know that really sets up for the V-trigger more than anybody else, because he's always going for the V-skill.
Yeah, he always wants to build the V-gauge more than any other player. Oh, got the autocorrect juggle. Man.
But of course, Ino, very strong player, long-time player.
Oh,
very,
what a
oh yeah. yeah. There he calls out the uppercut.
Such a clutch block. And this is Justin Wong versus Panda TV's Ren. Rashid player who made it super far in the bracket.
Yeah, we had a couple of really great Rashids here at Evolution. Ren being one of them, but you know, he's running into Justin Wong. Now remember, Justin,
I believe he took out Filipino champ, right?
I think so, yeah.
Right. Justin won this 2-0 for a record.
Yeah,
so he took it pretty convincingly. Oh, that was classic patented Justin Wong there. To open you up.
Forward, back, low forward, catches him, and that super always does way more damage than it looks like it should.
Yeah, and this is Hugo 101 versus Phenom, and Hugo 101, really the dark horse of this tournament, I think.
Yeah, he's a great player. He was really great in Street Fighter 4, but not a lot of people really... you know, he's never really quite had that shine. He's been really kind of hiding in the shadows for a while here in Southern California.
He had that second place finish at SCR one year. You can see Phenom went to Bison in this game here. He actually lost his set 2-1. You can see he got the W there with Bison in that game. But, you know, Hugo 101 ended up being able to hold it out.
All right, and you can see right here, sitting on a full bar.
Yeah, such a dangerous spot to be. And, you know, Phenom's trying to fight it out with Bison, who's the character that he beat Daigo with, and there it is.
Yeah.
So much damage and V-trigger.
And challenging just right after that V-trigger. I felt like that Phenom did that cancel maybe a little too late. You know, the block stun was maybe a little further off than he thought. And this is here is Kazunoko going up against Chun-Li specialist Ludovic.
Yeah, wow, what a way to close it out. So much damage, what a confirm from Kazunoko. He took this set 2-0 over Lud, who's one of America's strongest players, I think.
Yeah, he's been doing really well with Chun-Li at a lot of the major events, but Kazunoko, of course, you know, last year winner, of course, of the Capcom Cup. He's kind of good as well.
Yeah, definitely a talented player. You can see him close it out. Huge damage output on that. Next up, we have Itabashi Zangy versus Eita. You can see tucking him in real quick. It was a 2-1 in favor of Eita, whose Ken play is fantastic. He has some of the most fun Ken play because he's not afraid to take risks. He really understands that his character has cool damage output, that he can just go in there and take risks. Oh, man. Itabashi.
Speaking of taking risks, a backdash in the corner.
You slippery scoundrel, you.
I mean, it's kind of funny because obviously with guys like Momochi, you know, and sometimes we forget about some of the other Ken players from Japan. Eita, definitely one of the strongest ones as well.
Oh, yeah, definitely. He was an Akuma player. Oh, see, that's the kind of risk that Eita takes with Tatsu uppercut. Wow.
Wow, a lariat against the Air Hurricane. That's going to make it so that Itabashi takes this second game.
Yeah, but as we mentioned, Ada's going to be able to close it out 2-1 in the set. So he did end up being able to clutch it out here, as you're about to see.
Last round, last game.
Yeah, super close. And that's just the thing about Ada, is like you never know exactly what he'll do. So like, oh, okay, he was looking for throw tag. Itabashi held out. But man, just his Ken style is so interesting. You have to remember, Itabashi, what? Oh my god, that was so ridiculous.
Yeah, he just went for it, and it paid off, and there it is, Eita over Itabashi. And of course, we also had Phenom, who did super well at DreamHack Austin. He's going up against Filipino Man, who was making that crazy run that everybody talked about losing in the first round and going all the way through. and he lost the first round, and he has played more. He's basically lost the first round at about 10 a.m. and hasn't stopped playing since then.
No, definitely hasn't. He beat Phenom 2-0, and you know, he beat Haitani Nakali early on in the circuit as well. He's one of those guys that is just so threatening. He doesn't maybe travel quite as much as a lot of players, but his Chun is so explosive, so difficult to deal with, and it's so insistent on its own ideas, you know?
Yeah, and look, Filipino Man is no stranger to this. Throwing the V reversal. He has gotten ninth place. Oh, wow, he went for the slide, and that was probably...
That was probably
cost him, yeah. That's it right there. But
so those were the matches that happened off stream. So in case you guys feel like you missed out, just a little highlight reel, just a smidgen of some of the action going on at EVO. 5,000 players. And it was great to take a peek at some of the matches we had off stream, James, but I'm ready for these winners' top eight qualifying matches. I don't know about yourself.
And look, the first match that we're going to have starting up, you can't see it on stream right now. We can see the players right now. They are sitting there head in hands. Look at them. They are...
Oh, man, they both are. It's terrifying.
Dude, like, yeah, I know, right?
You know what this reminds me of? Tokido Daigo earlier?
Yeah,
when they both just were looking down. It was like an anime. I've never seen this in my life. They're both looking down, and then all of a sudden, like... They both looked up at the same time and hit start. And I was like, what? I actually screamed out loud in my chair. Yeah. I was so frightened.
But this first matchup that we're going to have for you to qualify, winner's side, Evolution 2016, is going to be Gamer B versus Infiltration. This was losers finals last year.
This is top three of EVO last year.
That's right. And it is happening right now to get into top eight.
Just to qualify in winner's side
That's
of top
right.
eight. It's not even, you know, like, it's not deep in the bracket. It's not winner's finals of the tournament. It's just to make top eight.
And you know what's really interesting to me is I actually feel like Gamer B has had an easier, I'm not saying an easier path, but he's been playing a little bit stronger. Infiltration had some close games.
He's been tested.
Yeah, he lost the first game to ROM. You know, and then he was able to make the comeback, as Infiltration is able to do.
Yes.
But Gamer B and Infiltration, two guys who have made numerous top eights during the Street Fighter 4 period, and they have just been given the go to play. You can see them both sitting there concentrating, but here they go. It is probably going to be Nash versus Nakali.
Yeah, that's what you would expect out of these two, although we know that Infiltration... He's been talking about his pocket characters, has played one a bit, but I don't expect him to start out with one right away. The handshake, and it looks like we're going to be into it so soon.
So we definitely, once again, we started with so many countries represented here in this tournament, and it has always been a very international game, and we're starting here right now with Korea versus Taiwan.
Yeah, that's going to be it. Razor Infiltration on the left with Nash. Gamer B on the right with Nakali, as we mentioned. It's going to be a zoner versus the character who wants to get in there.
And check out the background.
Check out this stage. Have you guys seen this yet?
Check this out. Here we go. Let's go. Evo in the background.
And top eight qualifying match. Gamer B already trying to move forward and get some of the space down. He hasn't busted out the B skill yet. But Infiltration Nash is so mobile. It's really tough to pin him down with stuff like that. What a whiff punish.
Man. Oh, wow. And that knee. Infiltration uses that as an anti-air better than anyone else. Uses it at the range where it's deceptive. It looks like he can't hit you, so you don't hit a jump attack.
Right. And almost he has no other anti-air option at that range. And that forward light kick, the knee that you just saw, such an excellent tool to do it. You see that you know, as Nash, you don't want to throw fireballs before he V-skills. You want to wait until after he does that little size mo and then bring out the fireball after. And that's what Infiltration's been doing.
What a confirm. Comboed into the Sonic side. Oh, opportunity for Gamer B, but didn't quite confirm into the ground.
Yeah, he did that low medium kick a bit late.
Oh, that should be punishable, yeah.
Yeah, and there it is. He gets the meaty attempt. He has trigger popped. Oh,
chases it down, but nice throw tech. But there again, a chase down. But unfortunately, he spent a lot of meters so far, so he doesn't have anything for the super. And just the jump in from Infiltration, that jumping roundhouse from Nash.
That was one of the rare times Gamer B doesn't get an anti-air uppercut. Yeah. I feel like he has some of the most consistent anti-airs out of any top player.
Yeah, Gamer B has always had some of the strongest reactions out of anybody that we've seen during the Street Fighter 4 era. He continues it here. Both of them sitting on full bar. Both of them very dangerous. Crush counter?
Yeah, I love that. Confirm the meaty double whiff short into the standing light kick. All right, he's out of there and back in for pressure. Infiltration trying to regain some of this life that he's lost already.
Very important, though, that he's gotten out of that corner. Gamer B, though, probably not going to be bashful about spending that meter to finish this round off if he can get the hit.
Yeah, he's got a big lead, but he's got to find a way to close it out. Infiltration Nash, so slippery, so tough to deal with. I love that he's preemptively sticking out buttons. Gamer B. He's sticking them out at a range where they're not going to hit unless that happens.
Yep.
Infiltration moves forward.
Oh, wow. Roundhouse versus Roundhouse. Once again.
Air to air is good. Man, I love the way Infiltration slowed this neutral down quite a bit. There's the anti-air that we missed the first game, first round.
And he spends the meter on that. He's going to go into V-Drew. Great block on the overhead, but too far. Otherwise, that might have been Sand Jab into Sonic Sight.
Yeah,
he could have maybe got it. Yeah.
Ooh. He's not far off of this comeback. There could be one mistake for Gamer B, and he might be out of this. So quickly, there's the dash up from Infiltration. Yeah. You can't jump. If you jump that fireball and he gets the raw critical art, it's going to be done.
Yeah, so Gamer B probably just going to sit here trying to play patient. You see how he's not trying to go in?
If he dashes and hits a scythe through that V-skill. Oh, man. Oh, he didn't get it.
But he got the airborne hit.
Yes, hit out of the air. Otherwise, that would have been game one Infiltration.
And you know, that's one of the fortunate things of having an overhead that jumps in the air. If that was Ryu or somebody else, that they just would have gotten hit on the ground, and that would have been it.
We were talking about Infiltration putting a game on the board, but instead the last round.
And the nice thing about that is Gamer B did that without spending all of his bar, so he's sitting on this, but Infiltration also with a lot of meter, so very close in resources.
And critical R from Nicali just means that was a sick whiff punishment. It just means that any of these stomps, any of these confirms become so much more deadly for Nicali. Really what you can expect. Yeah, I love the seismo spacing. He doesn't bring it out so often that Infiltration knows.
Another jump. Here we go into the super. He just got the super. So he's going to do a lot of damage, but he has a big life lead. But again, Gamer B sitting on that full V-trigger, sitting on full super meter.
Got him.
Ooh.
Not quite enough. Yeah, he's got full gauge. You can see at the bottom right. He's going to bring it out overhead. Just out of range.
Look at that low forward, just threatening all day.
Oh, he had the prediction
on the jump.
Okay, he's going to pop the trigger. Does he spend critical art? No.
No, he's going to save it.
There's the regular throw. He needs a few more.
So one more
hit's going to do it.
But doesn't kill.
The combo. He could have done jab in a scythe.
Right.
Great blocks, and he challenged.
What an uppercut. Wow, Gamer B just throwing it all out there with that uppercut.
It was a huge risk. He's got the trigger. You can see the medium punch is buffered. Every time, it's buffered into the dash, just in case Infiltration moves in.
Yeah, the problem with it is right now is that Gamer B has no meter for that super, so he's going to need at least maybe one or two mix-ups. And there's only 12 seconds left on the clock.
There's got to be a dash in. You got to expect a dash in from Gamer B at this point. He's got to find his way in. There's short time. What can he do but the air to
beautiful.
Air?
Beautiful, yeah. Infiltration knew he was going
to
jump. He had to jump.
He had to.
At some point. And Infiltration had that all ready to go with the air to air.
Impeccable defense. It's for him to stay solid under pressure, to get into Evo top 8 and just hang out and wait. And as soon as there is the jump, boom, has the answer.
Man, how many times? I mean, like, this
That
is...
takes the incredible clutch.
Yeah, and look at these two players. I mean, we have seen these two up on this Evo stage so many times.
Round one.
Here it is, back into it. First game Infiltration. So close to closing it out in that second round, and it went down to the last one. He stayed solid, and we got to see if Gamer B can bring it back. Certainly not unfamiliar with this kind of match, this caliber. Overhead.
Whoa, what a bait! And look at that damage right there. Already down half life. And once again, Infiltration going back to, you know, that this movement that he's had. Gamer B's trying to track him down with those seismos, and he cannot lock him down.
And get the pressure. Yeah, he walks up for it. It's just the movement is so unpredictable. And also, he rarely takes a big risk with it. It's like forward dash, back dash, forward dash. It's never in a bad spot for himself, okay?
Ooh, but a little too far. And both of them unable to punish the low roundhouses, and Gamer B just goes in.
Oh, B reversal on the stomp just to get away. And now Infiltration, lots of space to work with.
Finally got one of those seismos to connect.
And you see him not throwing that many booms. It's very rare that he actually throws one. He just kind of hangs out, whiffs a lot of buttons, and wants to occupy space without risking anything. Big jump.
But it was too far for that stomp.
Yeah, he should have confirmed into the charge instead. Great block. And a challenge again from Gamer B.
Wake up buttons from Gamer B. I'm sorry, from Infiltration, and that's going to stop Gamer B's offense. Remember,
he dashed up and went for command throw. So now, Infiltration match point to make it into Evo top 8. Stomp confirmed from Gamer B, trying to keep up the offense. And just the dash up from Infiltration into the throw. One of the few times he's even done moonsault, too. Great space for himself.
God, look at this pressure right now in the corner. Gamer B trying to figure out how to get out of this situation. All right, gets the ground pound. So now, builds himself a little bit of space. But wow, perfect distancing on that knee. A combo into the stand light punch.
Just hanging out at such an amazing range. The dash in is good. Infiltration keeping up the pressure. And Gamer B is really on the back foot. He hasn't done anything offensive this round. There's the uppercut, and now there's the big chance. V-Gauge, stocked, pops it. Oh, he mistimed the throw. Now so much room for infiltration to get away, but he goes in and confirm. Infiltration, first player. Top 8 winners here at EVO.
And is that any surprise right now? He has been playing so strong all year long. Infiltration has qualified to be in your top 8 for the very first year of Street Fighter V. We started with 5,100. We already know one of them that's going to be playing tomorrow at the Mandalay Bay.
You see this guy, Nemo, up on the stage already coming up. We're going to have a little replay here. You can see some of the stuff Infiltration has. Yeah. That forward light kick. Perfect spacing on the Anteater. And look at that. Come on. Just knew the uppercut was coming out after the overhead. There wasn't even really any pressure he could get there. Gamer B just really felt the need to do it. But yeah, man, what a match from Infiltration. Yeah. It was such a close first game, and then you could just see the understanding in the second game. He just really knew what was going to go on. He really understood, like, this is what I need to do to close it out. This is what I need to do defensively to stay solid. And it was really good stuff from him.
All right. Also, just want to remind everybody that you can head over to Amazon.com/Capcom Pro Tour to pick up all of your official Capcom Pro Tour t-shirts. You've got the classic on the top left, the Furin Kazan on the bottom right, and in the middle there you see the Win, Rinse, Repeat 2016 Capcom Pro Tour.
Man, that shirt is too good. Win, Rinse, Repeat? That's absolutely incredible. Those actually look super, super comfortable as well. Not as comfortable as the Vertigear chairs we're sitting in, of course. ForGamerGear.com. Check it out on Twitter, Facebook, also at Vertigear. There's a coupon code you can see at the top of the screen there, EVO2016, to save 10%, and it's valid through the 18th, which I believe is tomorrow, yes.
That's right. It's valid for all of EVO weekend.
Sounds like a plan to me. Hey, guys, we're going to have some matches for you guys soon. These are all winners, top 8 qualifiers at EVO. So this is top 16. And if you win this match, you're going to be in top 8 winners tomorrow in the Mandalay Bay.
Right. And one of the players that's coming up onto the stream, probably not one that a lot of people have heard of, is Yukodon from Japan, the Nash player. But he did really, really, really well at a recent tournament in Japan, I believe it was. And I still remember when that event I was watching, and I was like, who is this Yukodon guy?
Yeah.
And a lot of people, a lot of the Japanese players saying that he has just been a strong player for a very long time. Made his way out to EVO. He knocked Tokido into loser's bracket.
Did.
And he's here going up against Nemo. Coming up
Yukodon,
right now.
He was known for his Nash play, and he plays online. He was a really highly ranked online player, and everybody vouched for him. He finally comes out to events. He beat Daigo in the first event he went to. Now he knocked out Tokido at EVO. He has a chance to make top 8 winners here. So Yukodon, Nash, and of course Nemo playing Vega.
Yeah, and I feel like this is such a good pick for Nemo because he's, I mean, remember he was a great Rolento player.
Right.
And I just feel like having a character with fast walk speed,
yeah,
good mobility, two different stances, I just feel like that this was just a really good pick for Nemo.
I think the most important thing, he can play super fast, great footsies, great walk speed, frustrating offense. I think those are things that Nemo looks for. Not necessarily, you see wake up buttons from him. He's a very active player. He's going to hit lots of stuff, do lots of things, and try to get in your face. Yukodon, he's going to have to slow it down. It's not easy. The walk speed from Vega makes it so tough for this character to zone.
Yeah, but so far, Yukodon doing a great job. He's actually been the slipperier one and gets the throw bait. Meaty Sonic Boom tried to go right back in there. You saw that point-blank forward dash.
Yeah. Oh, did the late cancel slide into trigger? You can actually interrupt that if you hit a really early button. Great confirm, and it's going to be enough for the first round. Yukodon, Nash.
Yukodon coming here to EVO 2016. How many people do you think had Yukodon in their brackets to be able to get to top 8?
I don't even know. Maybe not even Yukodon. Dash in. He looked for throw bait, didn't find it, and because of that, Nemo takes advantage.
Right, goes for that meaty crouch fierce, but good block from Yukodon. Not
trying to escape. Ooh. Oh, dropped the combo, but he gets out of there. All right, there's the V reversal, or V trigger. Dash. Oh, man, I'm surprised he got that low profile there on the jump. Nemo in. And you can see there's... Yeah, I love the interrupt from Yukodon. He's been really great at stuffing the approach from Nemo, which isn't easy to do.
And there again. So, yeah, he has to use that V-trigger. It's unfortunate because basically spending that just to escape. Ooh, going for a little bit of the side switch and then the command throw. Not quite enough.
Yeah, just a little bit more to close it out. Great blocks from Yukodon. sitting on that full critical art as well.
There it is. Yeah, Kassen's going to be able to be a combo into there.
It has such a relevant thing at the end. Is it going to be enough to close it out? And it is. First game, Yukadon. Looking to be our second Nash player in top eight. Yeah. Clutch defense from him, and he sticks out the jab scythe, and he confirms into the critical arc. Great work.
I mean, it's funny because, like, that's something that you expect, you know, all Nash players are looking for. Yeah, it's just, it's so common. We've seen it land so often.
Yeah, it just becomes, any jab turns into critical arc from this character when he has the gauge, and it's so dangerous to deal with. Love the block from Nimmo, though. Usually, you know, he's not always blocking. A lot of times he's doing other things and trying to be active. But, yeah, that was a good time to just kind of hang out.
All right, nice anti-air again.
Oh, man. Nemo, three jumps in a row. So impatient on the way in.
Yeah. Trying to just not be discouraged from the jumps. Because, you know, if Yukadon anti-airs it every time and you stop jumping, then he's done his job and prevented an option from you.
Exactly, yeah. You can't let him get you convinced so easily. Now corner pressure for Nemo. There's a throw tech. What side? Great block.
Wow, he's still jumping in there, but Yukadon is going to be able to confirm off of that hit, and he is at match point.
Three rounds straight over Nemo, one of the favorites from Japan. Super talented player, and now full gauge as well for Yukadon, and none for Nemo. Got to be careful. Any button, scythe, huge damage. Oh, punish, of course.
Oh, he's not going to spend the meter just yet. He wants to save it just in case.
That time, Yukadon did go for throw. He baited it so many times that Nemo just didn't expect it.
And Yukadon has had his anti-airs on point.
Oh, 100%. He understands how Nemo likes to play. You can tell that he is really, he's either played him before or done his homework. Antier again.
Yep.
Tries to get in there. Delay on the low medium punch to frame trap. Man, I love the pressure. I love the defense. Cancels to keep himself safe.
But a little too far to be able to confirm into the super. Here comes Nemo once again. He's going to get in there with the... He didn't confirm into the super.
Yes, use the rose at the end. Going to get the setup. Love the dash.
Oh, beautiful.
He could have probably
movement.
Done raw scythe to punish. Okay, and still not out of this. One hit will do it. If Nemo gets frame trapped or anything, any kind of scythe, he lands it. Scythe, and he spends it. Yukadon is in top eight of Evo, just like that.
Yukadon, Nash. So actually now we have two Nash players qualifying for top eight.
And convincingly, Infiltration struggled a bit there against Gamerbee in the first game. Brought it back, and Yukadon clean sweeps Nemo to qualify for top eight. And man, that was crazy. And you know, as a reminder, Nemo top eight last year at Evo in Street Fighter 4. What a crazy match. And this is the defense we're talking about. It's he just the walk back, and he sneaks in just the jab. That's all he needs.
And then right
the one
here,
jab
yeah.
confirm. Instant.
I mean, that's the thing too, is that's not safe. The jab in the scythe is not safe. And they're just going for it, you know, in that situation. And
with just such little life left, it's one of those things that why not?
Right.
Why not try it? You know,
exactly.
I have such a deficit. I'm up a round. I can take a risk like that. Mm-hmm. He does. It works out. And because of that, he gets the game. Good work from Yukadon. Yeah.
All right. So coming up next, we are going to have Hugo 101, a.k.a. Kenneth Pope, from the USA, one of the U.S. hopes to get into the winner's top eight against MOV from Japan. But before we get there, we're going to take a quick break. So stick around, guys. Welcome back to Evolution 2016. We're going to jump right back in the action. And there you see one of US's last hopes. Sitting there on the right, Mr. Kenneth Pope, formerly known as Hugo 101,
yep.
but has entered the tournament as Kenneth Pope, wants to be known by his real name. And he is going up against MOV from Japan.
Chun-Li. He's a real terror, not only in this game, but in many games with Chun-Li, right? Super sick footsie, super sick offense.
In third
really
strike,
player.
Yeah. In third strike, I always like telling the story. He said that his Chun-Li should be banned because it cannot be beaten.
Well, it looks like it might just make top 8 at EVO this year, so maybe this game it applies too.
Well, Hugo 101 getting to this point a little bit under the radar with Nikali.
Yeah, sneaking in there. What a punish. Dash up, crouching fierce, the max stuff.
Yeah, like two dashes to get up there.
Yeah, wake up buttons. MOV sensed that there wasn't a meaty. And after that dash, the disguidance from Nikali, often you can't meaty. So great confirm on counter hit back strong as well.
Close
oh,
stun.
Yes, 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 yes.
Low profile, the uppercut.
Yeah, so Chun-Li can just walk up and do crouching medium kick, and it's almost spooky in the way that she just gets under it like that. Good work. So MOV. First game really understood, or first round really showing his knowledge. What a confirm too.
All right, let's see if Hugo 101 can. I'm sorry, Kenneth Pope can get anything going here. I mean, he, like I said, he's been playing this for a long time. Hopefully, he's not getting a little bit intimidated by the stage right now.
Yeah, I hope not. It's here at Evo. It's on the big stage. Got to impress in front of everybody. MOV so far just shows such an understanding, though. Okay finally, this, the meaty.
But again, a double dash and MOV showing that he is ready to start challenging his dashes.
Yeah, that's great work. Okay, you see the low strong. Didn't confirm it anything. I love the double low jab from MOV.
Ooh,
stomp.
Okay.
Oh,
but
dude,
again,
keep it up.
A little bit too aggressive. Trying to dash in there. Hoping that MOV was just going to block.
Oh, confirm. What? MOV could have kept it up, but he didn't. Oh, he
oh,
got him.
He just supered right through
and
there.
Through.
And yes.
It's going to be the round. Great work. Spent a
is.
Lot of meter on it, though.
Final round. Fight.
All right.
We're into it. Jumping is good. And he gets the confirm, but a little too far for that low strong after.
What a beautiful dash under from MOV to get the punish on the other side.
Oh, we baited the throw even, too. I like the work. There's the counter hit confirm. We've seen that a few times. Real meaty this time. And, you know, when he, as soon as he establishes the meaty, he's like, all right, you're going to, you know, hit buttons on my wake up. I'll just do this invincible reversal.
But they're both sitting here equal life. Oh, he's got
what
the hit.
What a confirm. That was ridiculous.
Yeah, but no super. Using the dive kick to get in there.
Oh, he gets the combo. Yes, yeah, spinning bird. What's the guess? Does he do the low medium kick?
Oh,
he blocked. Okay, and got the punish, I'd assume. I hope that was, and not just a missed block on the overhead.
There it is, MOV. I mean, look, it was interesting because MOV had done something on his wake-up so many times in a row, and it almost felt like right there at the end, Kenneth Pope was just like, dang you, I'm going to do this myself, and went for the uppercut. MOV baited that out, blocked it, was able to punish.
Yeah, it's like he must do something, right? There must be some kind of action here, and it just wasn't. Oh, yeah, in there, he's really done a great job sensing the size. Well, missed the air legs, actually, right there, so that jump medium kick as well.
No, that time, got it that time, and confirms into the full combo. Chasing him down, getting him towards the corner, close to stun.
Yeah, can keep it up. Great block. Oh, man, just dash up and put them back in the corner. Scary spot to be if you're MOV, but there's the B reversal.
Yeah, I really like that B reversal, just kind of trying to shut down the offense. And there it is, MOV getting in there, confirming the combo. Try to look like bait another wake-up uppercut. Oh, too far, but
oh,
is
can
that
punish?
Punish?
And there's the critical already.
Yes,
spend get
the round. Spend it, and he's going to get that round.
Yeah, always worth it to close out the round. Get the W there. Great work from Kenneth Pope.
Especially
although,
with that close in life, I mean, look how little health he had left.
Just a tiny little smidge in there. But yeah, MOV's control in the neutral has been so difficult so far. There hasn't been a lot of anti-airs from him, though. Only an anti-air jab from him. Now corner carry, he's going to be able to get in there. Keeps up the offense. Love to confirm. Already stunned. What's going to be the combo?
He's got a lot of meter. Oh, so he's just going to go for the maximum combo there. Keep
yes,
that meter.
Crush.
Oh!
And there's the uppercut from Kenneth. He still has V-Trigger available, and he pops.
Yep, goes for the cross. Wow, a standing medium punch challenge.
Just let it rip.
That was a punish on the missed air legs, but he wasn't able to confirm it into anything. He wasn't V-trigger. He should have been able to get the charge even without the without charging up for it.
Yeah, you don't have to charge when you're in V-trigger. You just hit the input for the move.
As long as it's a cancel. As long as it's a cancel.
Yeah, so now MOV looking so great. There's the anti-air he needed in the other round.
Oh, under beautiful, the getting. I mean, that's Chun-Li's walk speed for you right there.
Oh, yeah, 100%. Wake up jab. Love the confirm again from Kenneth Pope.
And just playing it safe afterwards.
Not doing,
that's a punish.
Didn't get anything bigger, but there's another counter hit confirm. He's done such a great job of turning all his hits into damage so far.
Gotta be careful. So MOV sitting on a full bar. Any
that's
hit now.
That's so dangerous. That fierce. That could be critical art at any range. He's going to hit it.
That
confirm.
Was that linked? It was linked.
It looked like it.
And MOV has he...
And that is it.
Yes. MOV has advanced forward. He joins Infiltration and Yucadon in the top eight.
See him needing a breather there after that one. Great work from him. So, Kenneth not out of the tournament yet, right? He's going to drop down into loser's bracket, but only needs one more for top eight here at Evo. And there you see him. One of America's last hopes, L.I. Joe, and up on the stage.
I don't know if you guys at home can hear the reception that he's getting, but he is one of the most popular players here, one of truly beloved players in the U.S., and he is coming up against Fudo, and the audience is definitely got his back.
Oh, yeah, 100%. Of course, you know, hometown in the U.S., I guess. You know, he's obviously not from Vegas, but... he's going to have the audience on his side on this one. He's going to be playing against Fudo.
All right. And Fudo, of course, one of the strongest players from Japan. But before we get into this match, we're going to take a look at some videos here for you guys. Definitely check out the Score Esports. You can stay on top of all of the Super Smash Bros. And Street Fighter V action at EVO with the Score Esports app. You know, just check it out. It has all the results, breaking news, interviews, and highlights as well. So it's available currently on Android and iOS. Check that out right now.
I'm sure they'll have the score for the match that's coming up right now as soon as that's over, of course. L.I. Joe Nash player from the U.S. of A versus Razor's Fudo of Japan, who's going to be playing Mika. He beat Luffy in the mirror match to make it here just a little bit ago. That was on the Capcom Fighter stream. And now he's going to be playing against L.I. Joe's Nash. It's going to be an interesting matchup. He's got to make it through.
Yeah.
The zoning, the normals, the control from Nash. And we'll see if he can get in there.
L.I. Joe, of course, had early success here in the States when Street Fighter V first dropped.
Yeah.
Hadn't been able to perform as well, but here he is in this chance to get to top eight winners. Of course, Fudo, when first went to Mika, a lot of people were like, what? This character doesn't make any sense. But
definitely a surprise.
It has made so much sense as Fudo has gotten stronger and stronger with this character.
Now, one thing you'll notice about Joe's Nash right away in comparison to the other two we've seen, a lot more offense, a lot more in and out. He doesn't want to just play the zoning game. He's going to go in and make stuff happen, which is why you see he got the hit here. Fudo's going to be able to corner carry. V-trigger available as well. He can get it if he finds a hit,
and
although
it's
a throw.
Here comes all the Mika mix-ups.
Another
goes
one.
Goes for another crouching throw.
Another for stun. He's going to get it. Has V-trigger available. pops it for the maximum damage, and that'll do it. Yeah, Nadeshiko would have hit after. He could have done Peach out of the air. It would have been a lot of damage. So Fudo, first round, pretty convincingly, just because Joe went in with one too many sights. Just got him caught.
Yeah, and that's what Mika does to you. I mean, that's the thing that makes Mika so scary, is that you can spend a whole fight keeping this character out. She gets in one time, done. That's it. Yeah, all your life gone.
True definition of a one-chance character. That's all she needs. And already corner carry. Fudo has moved him across the screen just by walking forward, really not taking any other risks. Air to air.
Yeah, I like that air-to-air jab. Oh, speaking of air-to-air jabs, good job. And he is going to spend the meter right now to try to get a huge lead in the second round. He's got a lot. I mean, if he can take this round, obviously, he's got a long way to build up a ton of more meter. He's going to get the hit into the roundhouse Sonic Sight, and that is going to take round two for L.I. Joe.
Yeah, what excellent work. He just got the confirm, made it in there. Great stuff to Joe. He's really, you know, kept himself alive here. Although, man, bad spot to be. I don't know about this dashing in that he's doing so often. I feel like, you know, it got him caught in the first round, and it's, you know, he's taking a lot of damage this round because of it as well.
All right, trying to keep up that pressure, but backs off just a little bit. Goes back to the Sonic Boom game.
Yeah, slowing it down a bit. No answer here.
But didn't confirm into a big old combo.
Yeah, he was expecting there to be a throw tech or something. He's tried a few of those against Fudo so far. Yeah. Hasn't bit. Pressure, and you see throw tech OS from Fudo. That was that jump back light kick.
But I really like Joe's jump back light punch defense. He's been playing it.
Oh, it's gonna whip. Got the grounded punch.
Was that intentional? Because if that's so, that is sick.
Yeah, that was really interesting from Fudo.
V reversal leading into way more damage. He's gonna confirm into the EX Flying Peach.
Yeah, great. Oh, he got him out of the air, but not a full juggle. Throw. Fudo closes out the first game. What a crazy scramble it was. But he holds on. Good work to him.
Yeah, again, that V reversal, if that was an intentional thing, because he had that ground combo right away, I feel like he knew about that. Turning a small V reversal potential damage into a full combo into corner carry.
Yeah, use the invincibility frames on V reversal to get through the entire site. That was really, really sick stuff. All right, into the match again. Joe with the dash up. No confirm. That roundhouse is supposed to be roundhouse site. He just didn't get the input.
Yeah, a little bit of nerves hitting Joe now.
Not a good sign. He's got to stay solid here against one of the strongest players from Japan. Just in the world. He's got pressure. Jump over. I like that Joe just backs off. Yeah, he doesn't go in too hard there.
I want to say that right now it's got to be a little risky for Joe. He's done a lot of backdash and then forward dash, and Fudo's got to have recognized that as well. But
another drop from Joe. That's too bad. There's the command throw from Fudo. He hasn't brought it out a ton.
Oh, and this time he techs it. Gets out of there. Tries to chase her down and misses. So now Fudo has the opportunity. What's the mix-up? Stays in the front. Gets the command throw. Is this enough to stun? Not quite.
And because it wasn't, Joe has a chance. He gets the sight. What's it going to be from Fudo? Dash in, out. So risky from Joe.
Yeah, like I said, he's going out.
Overhead. What a block and a punish. He's got a guess on the right thing.
Oh, and he gets the counter hit towards medium kick, which is going to be able to link it and stand jab. Fudo now at match point.
So moving to top eight here at EVO over Joe. And you see, I really feel like it's the dashes. He's got to be so mindful of giving up all that space. He tried to jump away, couldn't get it. Now Fudo opening up.
Fudo using a different jump button and hitting it early because he knows that's what Joe wants to do, is that jump jab.
One more for stun. Oh, it still is. Yes, and Fudo, so much to work with. Mix up here, front or back? Front, and a block from Joe.
Joe in the long road to try to get out of here, but
that's gonna be it. Fudo over L.I. Joe. He's gonna move into top eight tomorrow at the Mandalay Bay, and I think a player that some people sort of don't consider it super at the top, but lately Fudo has looked incredibly impressive.
Yeah, exactly. And, you know, a matchup between two players here, two of the nicest players from their respective countries.
Oh, yeah, 100%. Really, really, really great guys. If you haven't talked to them or been at an event with them, really nice. So we're going to take a peek at that V-reversal shenanigans that Fudo came out with.
Watch this.
So it just whiffs and a punish. That is so clean from him.
That
understanding
so
of his
sick.
Character. Man, I couldn't believe that. That is just really next level stuff.
Yeah, I mean, that's just doing a lot of research there. And there you see the stand jab confirm into the EX Peach and the,
Yeah, that's ridiculous. That forward medium kick, fantastic stuff from him.
Yeah.
It's immediate. It'll cover back roll or quick rise, right? So no matter what you do there, you're pretty much stuck. It's good work from him.
Yeah. So Fudo is now the fourth person on the winner's side. That is going to be Fudo. That is going to be MOV. Infiltration. It is going to be MOV. And the last player was
Yukadon. Three Japanese players, one Korean player, and top eight winners here at Evolution.
I actually saw someone on Twitter, Mr. Fox, actually mentioned to me that Yukadon could almost be considered this year's II, because remember, II just kind of came out of nowhere with the jury last year and made top eight, and now Yukadon. And again, like I said, we saw him in some of the other streams, and we know he's a good player, but definitely doesn't have the name recognition as a lot of these other guys.
Yeah, to get top eight here at EVO.
Yeah, 5,100 down to top eight, and he's one of them.
So. And I got to imagine this is his first U.S. tournament, right? First time traveling overseas to play. Makes it into top eight winners convincingly with Nash.
Yeah, what a way to make a splash here at Evolution 2016. But yeah, so obviously we've had some great Street Fighter matches all day. A lot of great matches in every game.
In all kinds
actually,
of games. Actually,
yeah, we had four games finished today with some of the craziest finishes that we that we've seen in recent memory. So, and it's all going to keep going tomorrow. It's going to be the nutsiest thing.
8 a.m. in the Mandalay Bay.
That's right.
Ultra David and the other MK commentators sleeping.
Yep.
Right now, so that they can catch up and see you guys all in the morning at Mandalay. It should be an awesome time. I'm so curious to see how it goes. It should be awesome.
Yeah, it's going to start with MKX tomorrow, and it's going to be followed by Ultimate Marvel vs. Capcom 3, then with Guilty Gear Xrd Revelator. And then followed by Super Smash Bros. Melee, topped off by Street Fighter V simulcast here on Twitch.tv as well as ESPN2.
Yeah, that is an absolutely ridiculous lineup. And it'll be happening all day. So you guys will have something to tune in and watch all day on Sunday.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
It's going to – wait a minute.
Oh, James. Breaking news.
Breaking news here from Evo. I'm going to head over to our correspondent, Esports. James, tell me what you heard.
Hey, Seijo, I'm here out in the field, and I've just gotten word that we actually have one more match for you guys on this stream.
Another match, James? What could it be?
That's right. Before we get to that match, which is coming up, we're going to have one more match for you guys, but definitely, once again, check out that Capcom Pro Tour store, amazon.com/CapcomProsTour, and grab your official Pro Tour tees.
Yeah, definitely check them out. They look cozy, comfortable, all kinds of nice. I would definitely recommend getting one and just showing up to these events, hanging out. You can also check out, of course, the boys over at Cross Counter. You know them, Lord Goots, Miguel Rossington, the whole crew over there. You can check out this EVO weekend deal and Sunday at midnight tomorrow. So once you guys finish up watching some Street Fighter and all the other games happening, head over to the site, check it out for sure. Get their online shows, books, etc., as well as the EVO merch. It's going to be evomerch.com. You can see all the lovely things. I recommend checking out that Varsity jacket, which you see in the second column in the middle there, as well as that jacket in the upper right. Those ones in particular, I think, look just real snazzy.
I say I'm a fan of the 8-bit Evo.
You know? 8-bit shirt.
The old school. The old school. Let's do it. Yeah. But once again, we have one more match for you guys coming up on stream. So don't go away. It's going to be Kazunoko versus L.I. Joe. So this is to be able to get into top 8 on the loser side bracket. And if I'm not mistaken, Kazunoko was sent to losers pretty early.
I feel like he's made a track through loser's bracket now that I think about it. Yeah, he's going to be playing against Joe. Should be Cammy versus Nash. It's going to be similar to the matchup you just saw.
Right.
Cammy's going to be on the approach, on the prowl, and Joe's got to keep the defense up. We'll see if he can do it. One of the things he sort of struggled with was when those dash-ins happened, he just got intercepted. So I'm curious to see if that's an issue for him against Cammy.
Yeah, and of course, Kazunoko, you know, Capcom Pro Tour champion last year. You know, won a sweet little $120,000 at that event, you know, beating Daigo in Grand Finals. Very strong player. I feel like at first kind of started with Cammy, was trying to play her a little bit more aggressively. It wasn't working out. And he's actually made the great adjustment. You know, he stuck with the character. He didn't change. He's been playing a little more carefully. He's been playing more fundamentally, and it is starting to pay off for him really, really well.
Yeah. He, you know, it's not like he's never not been a great fundamental bass player. I feel like he just realized, like, all right, maybe I should slow it down with this character. And not because he doesn't have great reads or anything like that, but she has such low health that you can only afford to take so many risks.
I mean,
you know, you saw him play against Itabashi at that tournament recently.
Right.
And Itabashi landed like 3 SPDs and she was dead. That was like the whole round. And the whole round was like an air SPD and 2 grounded ones. And it was like, well, it was a good round.
I mean, I still remember the story, though, when Kazunoko first started playing Street Fighter. He picked it up in AE and he started playing Yun. And he said the reason why is because he came from Guilty Gear. And he's like, I don't have those footsie fundamentals in Street Fighter. I just want to go crazy.
Yep.
But you know what? Maybe he was joking, but whatever the case is, you're right. His fundamentals are on point now.
Some of the best reads on his own wake up, right? On
yes.
whether I as Kazunoko should wake up uppercut, wake up jab, wake up low forward, wake up backdash, throw, whatever it's going to be. He's really, really active on his own wake up, and he's good at pinning you down and getting his offense.
And here we go, L.I. Joke going up against Kazunoko.
You see the early jump into dive kick from Kazunoko to beat the anti-air attempt. There it is again. Joe gets under, though.
Yeah, the dive kick just falling a little bit short. No challenge against the V skill. Joe gets the dash under, fake cross under into throw.
And you see Joe block, expecting uppercut from Kazunoko, and he's already hitting a button there. Just knows that, yeah, people will respect me, I'm Kazunoko, ooh, and I might uppercut.
Just barely clipped that EX dive kick, and here comes Kazunoko. But you know what? You're kind of willing to take that forward throw from Cammy when you're not in the corner, because you definitely do not get as much pressure follow-up from Cammy after that.
Yeah, mid-screen, it doesn't lead to much at all. Not too dangerous, and trigger's just about gone for her. Great work. You know, Joe has baited uppercut 3 or 4 times, and Kazunoko hasn't done it.
And so this time he does the cross under, goes for the combo,
and ends right overhead.
Overhead, L.I. Joe taking the first round.
Yeah, that was lovely stuff. He baited the uppercut a few times, Kazunoko got away with buttons, and he's like, all right, I will commit to my own offense and make something happen, and that's what he did.
All right, nice, using the EX Sonic Scythe.
Oh, okay, wow, just out of range for the full thing, but still. I think Kazunoko will take that. That's 2 bars already spent from Joe.
But yeah, Joe has really done a great job kind of shutting down the dive kick game from Kazunoko, getting 2 Sonic Sights and then punishing it with a low forward on the whiff. But here comes Kazunoko. This is where Cammy gets scary.
The walk-up throw attack, anti-air from the back strong. And man, Kazunoko's in a dangerous spot. A throw will stun, so he's got to be careful. Out of there is Joe.
I love that crouching short real quick. And then that jump back jab that we saw him use so much against Fudo.
Oh, he's going to get through with the drill. Bends it. Yeah, huge damage on that. Just needs one more to close out this round. Joe in trouble here. Not a lot of resources to work with. He's getting close to critical R, but not quite in there.
It
is.
Love
to confirm. He even confirmed uppercut just in case to get that extra bit of damage if drill wouldn't have killed. So,
last
round.
1-1.
We'll see if
this first game.
Maybe Joe can slow it down. He's close to critical R, and there's, yeah, Kazunoko through.
Not a huge amount of damage, but this is what Cammy needs. It just gets you in, and it starts her game. She's so threatening.
Oh,
big damage. He's going to spend the EX instead of saving it for the super.
And it was huge damage. I totally agree with it. Now he's got to be careful.
Hoping maybe he could build up another bar possibly to get the super confirmed towards the end of this round. But just, you know, he's just trying to kill off the time of that V-trigger, and he did it.
Oh,
so she's only had one move. Didn't go for the EX Sonic Scythe.
Block from Joe, hanging out, got the confirm, and that's going to be enough. First game, L.I. Joe over Kazunoko.
And look at L.I. Joe, he knows, and you know what, in the background, Moons, his L.I. training partner, one of his best friends, cheering him on, the audience chanting Joe.
He just needs one more for top 8 here at EVO, and he's got to keep up this defense. That's the most important part. I feel like I was just going to say there's a jump, but besides that, ooh, Joe has done such a great job of being a wall and just stopping all these dive kicks, as you mentioned.
Wow, one of the first time Kazunoko's kind of gone for that throw tick, and Joe actually teched it, but here comes Kazunoko again, getting the counter hit from Joe pushing buttons, and that's a stun, not quite yet.
No, one more for stun. Great block, but then opened up by the low. This should be a clean round for Kazunoko, and it is.
That's always a discouragement if you're the person who wins the first game and then all of a sudden the opponent comes back and wins a solid first round.
Yeah, convincing stuff. We saw that opener last time. Kazunoko dashes and then buffers just in case he throws a fireball. As soon as you do, EX drill right through. keeps up the pressure. Counter hit confirms.
Yeah, Joe hitting buttons in those situations. And now Kazunoko's got Joe really flustered and confused about what he should do.
I think mostly he's tightened up the offense so much. Joe, there's no escape.
Oh, let's just do it.
Yeah, just reversal critical art. He's going to get a huge chunk of damage on this. He can have mix up here if he wants it. We'll see if he dashes in or not. He does.
Oh, but he drops the combo.
Oh, no. This is a huge swing. Great block from Joe.
And he avoids the trigger dive kick, but Kazunoko right on the cusp of it.
And the throw tech, yeah, gets beaten out by EX dive kick. Kazunoko ties it up so quickly.
Some Street Fighter 4 tactics right there. Instant EX dive kick from Kazunoko beating out the throw tech.
It's going to be one game apiece now. Joe, really, the defense there was not what it needed to be, right?
Yeah.
And it's so tough, the options. You know, the wheel of options that Cammy has, and Kazunoko, you know, switches between them so well.
And that's how Cammy beats you. You know, it's, you know, it sounds simple, throw or frame trap, but when it's executed so properly, it is so devastating to deal with.
Oh, mix up was so tough to see. Uses drill at the end of that for positioning.
Joe once again trapped in the corner, and again, same sequence, and Joe keeps hitting the button and then gets caught into the throw bait. Here comes Kazunoko, basically telling Joe, I have you figured out now.
Yeah, and the dive kick will do it. Kazunoko on three rounds straight after losing that first game over L.I. Joe, looking to move himself into top eight here at Evo. It's been clean, James.
Yes, these last two games have been all Kazunoko. Joe needs to figure out a way to get something established. Wow, a crouch short to beat the cross-up?
I wonder if that was DP, just didn't get the autocorrect. Reversal out, but a chase down. Kazunoko will not give Joe any space, and he really needs it.
Yeah, Joe can definitely feel the pressure right now, but okay, able to build that space. Ooh, block just in time.
Sticking out some more buttons. Joe doing a better job at intercepting now. Jump over.
There he goes. Kazunoko is in.
Great. He just ducked under it. One more V-trigger dive kick will do it for Kazunoko.
Didn't
he's almost out.
Confirm into the super, but he's going to be able to do it here.
Spends the critical art.
Is this enough to be able to take out Cammy? Low health, 900 health.
It'll not do it. Just needs one. And yeah, you see him back that. She didn't want to get hit by the uppercut. That's a punish.
Okay, yeah. That's punishable. So Kazunoko kind of just took the risk there. But you know what? He's okay with that because he was down so much. And he's coming into this round with a two-bar resource lead.
Over Joe. And yeah, Joe's scared to throw fireball because of EX drill. Great first start to this game. Oh, he hit a button into that EX dive.
Yeah, he thought it was going to miss. Okay, not hitting buttons in that sequence this time. But confirms into the drill. Gets the throw. Close to stun.
Oh, late tech from Joe, and because of that, there's a mix-up.
Oh, but
he walked into it.
Kazunoko thought he was going to go to the other side. Challenge.
Air to air again. Joe gets the throw.
And now he has it close to stun. Chooses not to keep the pressure up, though.
Yeah, was scared of the V-trigger. All right, Kazunoko going to be able to confirm. Maybe spend the X. No. What a block again. Same sequence.
And he's going to confirm it. Super. Is it?
That's dead for sure. L.I. Joe is in top eight of EVO. He makes it.
I Joe, Long Island Joe from New York State has qualified for Evolution Top 8. He has made it. U.S. player has made it into Top 8. You can see the elation from Joe and all of his friends jumping up there and giving him a hug. No man deserves this more than L.I. Joe. You can see the emotion from him.
And Kazunoko up there for the hug. Good sportsmanship from him, but what a showing from Joe. Just so pleased. That was crazy. What a rally from him so deep there.
And the fist bump from Infiltration. You can see L.I. Joe is beside. I guarantee you he is so lightheaded right now. Like, he can probably barely stand up at this point in time. Oh, and there's his girl, Kat, coming up there, giving him the hug. L.I. Joe always having support from her.
And a Cinderella story for Joe to make it all the way here, lose that nail biter to Fudo, does it, beats Kazunoko, even gets the hug. Man, what a showing from Joe. Great job to him. He'll be playing in Mandalay tomorrow. You can see this is the end that closed it out. And Joe, that block.
What a block. That was it right there.
That was an EVO qualifying block if I've ever seen one in my life. And even gets the confirm. You see him jump up immediately. He knew it was over. And people on the stage already.
And there it is. L.I. Joe has qualified. But, you know, interestingly enough, three Nashes. Yucadon, Infiltration, as well as L.I. Joe now. Three Nashes. And, you know, we've all been talking about Ryu, Chun-Li, Ken. All this talk about those characters, it's almost like people kind of forgot about Nash.
He just really snuck in there, huh? And I think that, you know, he just played a matchup that doesn't look so fun for Nash. He really weathered the storm and survived. I think it's one of those things where the better player prevails.
Yeah. And he did it in almost the exact same way Yukodon did that. Let me just check you with Crouch Jab, Sonic Scythe. Let's do it. Let's do it. It worked.
Just input the super. We'll see what happens. If the critical art hits, you win, right? So it's one of those situations. That was fantastic stuff from Joe. Yukodon and Infiltration and top 8 winners as well.
That's
with
right.
Nash. So 3 Nash players at least. We don't even know who else is in. We only know of 5 players.
Right,
there's
exactly.
3 others that are going to qualify and losers that we don't know about. Or
right.
have already qualified, and you
that's
guys
true,
probably
that's
know.
That's true. Probably on some of the other streams.